So I didn't see any different. And I have never been in position one day for me to see them exchange word or say they are quarreling. I've never seen them.
He was my father's best man. And it seems ironic that the same man that signed my father's wedding register as his best man also signed his death warrant. Signed him to death. An untimely death. That's the irony of life. You see, they always try to quantum it up like Boutrous and, or is it Boutrous, the Shakespearean Caesar. Boutrous and Caesar. So who was the Boutrous, who was the Caesar in this affair? He was my father's best man. And it seems ironic that the man that signed my mother into womanhood also signed her into widowhood. All because of power.
The trial of Vatsa and eight other officers was hushed, hurriedly concluded in secret, and their execution was carried out against widespread appeals. March 1986, General Domkat Bali announced the execution of Mamman Vatsa and eight other officers. A shocked nation listened as General Bali, Babangida's defense minister and chairman Joint Chiefs of Staff, announced that Vatsa and others were executed 1 hour earlier.
But let us first look at those women who lost their lives, even like my wife who lost her life. Because of a case that I was roped in. A colleague says he told me, that's all. You don't look for another person to corroborate that fact. You don't look for hard facts, just weak circumstantial evidence. And he said, yes, this man must die. And in the process, you condemn him to die. And by divine intervention, he was brought back to life imprisonment. And in the process, his wife died. For goodness sake. And now, I don't know whether you listen very well to General Bali's statement. He said that those who were involved in coup were executed a short while ago. And that because there was doubt, and those who they had doubts about have been set free. In other words, they have been their death sentences have been committed to life. And we Moses Efion was one of those whose death sentences were committed to life. So in other words, they had doubt in their mind about my involvement. So if you have doubt, then you resolve it in favor of the accused. Why was I not discharged and acquitted? Or why was my death sentence not quashed and set free?
A sudden disquiet befell the nation. A devastated populace bore the shame with bowed heads and utter disbelief. 20 years after Vatsa was executed, his spirit seemed to have resurrected in his widow, Safia, who had borne the pain of his death since 1985. Safia rejects the claim that her late husband planned or led a coup.
The trouble is that the truth have been spoken, and it will continue to be spoken. How can you plan your coup by yourself? Executed your coup by yourself? And kill the people again by yourself? I'm not God. Who said when they slap you here, turn the other side. They slap again, you put your face, they blow it up. I still have to keep some part to watch what I'm doing. You are the coup planner by yourself. That very good that you just want to kill this man. You executed the coup, monitored the coup from beginning to the end by yourself. You hear me? Then you now take a decision to judge the people and kill them by yourself. Can't you see? Can Nigerians see? He is the master of planning of the coup by himself. Executed the coup by himself. And judging the people and killed them by himself. Can't you see? Do you notice it? Do you agree with what I'm telling you?
From what I heard, from what I heard from those arrested, and in the open court, some of those people, I say some, that's the operative word, some of those arrested owned up that they held meetings, two or three meetings, which they attended. One was at Makurdi, which some of them attended. One was in Lagos, which they said some of them attended. In fact, those who attended the meeting owned up. And during the court sitting, they asked this gentleman who accused me, did Moses Efion, whom you accused or whom you alleged to have been informed by you about the coup, did he attend any of the meetings? He said, no, he didn't attend any of the meetings. He was just sitting on the fence. What do you make of that as a court? What do you make of such statement? You know? So, back to, was there really a coup? Some people claimed that, you know, they had plans. Some people claimed that, you know? And, I mean, it was there in their statements, you know, that they had plans to carry out something. But concerning some accused persons, I mean, first, some of those accused persons, I, inclusive, Major Kwashiki, Major Edwin West, General Vasa, none of these four attended any of those meetings. None of these four. You know, and as I said in my book, there was no strong evidence against any one of us, any of the four of us, that is Vasa, myself, Akwashiki, and Edwin West, you know? And so for the court to have gone ahead to convict and even kill General Vasa, I find it difficult to, you know, to believe that justice was truly done. No.
Safia's pains are deep, and through her, the spirit of her deceased husband is demanding for justice.
To be very honest with you, we are not asking for revenge because we leave that to the Almighty. Because today, no matter what you are, if you are governor, you are president, you think you own the world, when the Almighty comes calling, you know, honestly, you cannot tell him I was governor, I was president. Then you will go. But all we want is for him as a person to be remembered that he fought to keep this nation together. He committed no crime. He was unjustly murdered. Right, life has no duplicate. Yes, if anybody and nobody today will come out and look at you and say, sorry, we killed somebody. Yes, because of the situation today, we agree. But all we want is just one. For him, you know, once you're tagged a coup plotter in this country, you lose all your benefits, your respect. Your family loses his respect.